Everybody, I'm Miss Man Man. Welcome to my channel. Today we are kicking off a brand new series which is in collaboration with my new blog series called The Pinup Pageant Guide. For the next little while, I will be releasing a whole bunch of blogs and videos all about pinup pageants. I am breaking down pageants into a lot of little sections and going through them in a lot of detail. This is sort of a list of things that I wish I had known and had been told when I started doing pageants, so I really hope it helps you out. I feel weird starting this series because I don't win every pageant that I enter. I've done a whole bunch of pageants. I love them, they're a lot of fun, but this guide is by no means the absolute way to win. There are never any guarantees, much like with anything in life. So everything has to have your own personal flair on it, but I really just wanted to release this as a way of spreading information. Everything is up on my blog, which I've already released the first two parts, so this video will be a conglomeration of that. Today we will be discussing how to write a pinup bio and how to send an application for a pinup pageant. So let's start with the pinup bio. What is a pinup bio? A pinup bio is a condensed biography which you send in as part of your application, and it's sort of a about me section, which is really short, and it's something that you can either show the judges or it might even be read out as part of your performance. This is a great way of sharing a little bit about you in a mini advertisement, but it is no way, shape or form your entire life story. Keeping it short, sweet, and sharp is the key. But why should I have a pinup bio? If you are a pinup, a burlesque artist, or a performer of any kind, a bio is a really handy thing to have. When you send an application for media, performances, pageants, or anything else, a lot of organizers will ask you for a bio. This bio is a chance to introduce yourself and have a really good first impression. Bios, of course, can evolve and change over time, so don't feel like this will define who you are forever. Right, let's now look at how to write your bio. Point number one, keep it short and keep it sharp. I would recommend between about 100 to 150 words. This is not your life story and people will get bored very quickly. What sort of information should you share? I would recommend sharing what kind of performer are you, something fun and quirky that maybe can make the audience laugh. If you want to add an achievement, that's fine as well, but don't brag about it. And maybe a little tidbit about your life. This is a chance to have some fun, don't waffle on, and sort of get to the point as quickly as you can. Quick tip, put something exciting and interesting first up in your bio to draw the audience's attention. What to avoid when writing your bio. As already said, this is not your life story. People don't really need to know where you were born, how long you've been doing pinup / burlesque, or any sort of mundane information. You can make up really fun tidbits and add little elements of your life, but try to keep it as short as interesting as possible. Tip number two, don't bother writing about how much you love pinup or burlesque. If you are participating in a pageant, the audience and the judges sort of know that you love pinup and burlesque because you wouldn't be there if you didn't. So say those words and write something else. I would also recommend you write your bio in third person. This means writing about you as a character with no I sentences. Tip number three, avoid false title statement. You might think it's really fun and quirky to call yourself the best pinup in the state, but if that's not a title that was actually given to you, don't bestow that upon yourself. My next point is show your personality. A bio is a great place to sort of use your personality to attract the audience. If you consider yourself hilariously funny, make people laugh. If you are more glamorous and vintage, take people on an elaborate and opulent journey with you. It's also a good time to highlight something that's signature about you, whether it be your amazing hair color or whether it be your curves. Find something that you think is your signature and add that into your bio. It is also important to stay on brand. You might think that pinups and comedy always tend to win on stage, but that is simply not true. Don't pretend to be hilarious when that is not who you are personally on stage. Tip number four, I think. Don't forget to include your pinup name in your bio. My next big point is don't just copy somebody else's bio. When hearing other people's bios, it's easy to think, oh, that's so funny, I love it, I want to use that for my own. Don't. It is really easy to unravel yourself and look unoriginal, which is not the title you want to bestow upon yourself. My last tip for writing a pinup bio is read it out to somebody and gauge their reaction. And now we come to part two, which is how to send in a pinup pageant application. Whenever you apply to a pinup pageant, the process is always going to be slightly different. My first piece of advice is to always read the application process carefully. From here, you will know exactly what you need, how much time you have, and what is required of you. Some pageants have a simple form for you to fill out. Go through this form carefully and take your time. You don't want to rush it. Use this form to add a little bit of personality and let people know who you are. For example, I've seen some girls be asked what is their favorite vintage car. It's all cute to sort of list a car, but if your favorite vintage car is in fact a motorcycle, write that. It's okay to show the judges that you think outside the box. My pageant application tip number one would be proofread everything. Make sure that there are no typos, no spelling mistakes, and everything is answered honestly and well. If in your application process you are asked if there's something you would like to tell the judges, use this space wisely. This is not the space to tell people how much you love pinup and how badly you want the title and what it means to you. This is the chance to sort of give them information that you think will help you. In your application process, also be honest. If they're asking you what charity work you do and what you do for community and you don't do anything, be honest. Maybe explain why and how much you would like to. It's okay to, you know, not be the most perfect person. Show them that. Before hitting send, check again. Yes, I know I've already told you check it once, check it again. Make sure you have filled out everything. If your application requires photos, have really well selected photos. Try to avoid selfies. Try and find professional photos. If you can't pay for professional photographs, maybe ask somebody to go out with a good camera or even your iPhone and find good lighting. We want to see your personality in the photos, so find something that's maybe a little bit silly or a little bit funny. I find it really helpful to have a folder on my laptop which I keep all my application photos in. I think it's good to have a headshot, a torso shot, and then a full body photo just to sort of show them who you are, and a couple of fun, silly, quirky shots. If your application only requires one photo, send in your favorite photo, preferably which is torso up. My next point is keep your photo tasteful. It's great that you love your body, but sometimes if it is a family-friendly event, these sort of photos might not be the greatest place. My last tip is don't over-edit your photos. I have seen some people send in submissions where they have used so many filters on their face, they don't even look like a human. They almost look Voldemort-y because they've completely flattened their skin. It's okay to have flaws. It's okay to have wrinkles. It's okay to have acne. Show people. You're not going to lose points because you have fine lines. Huh. You're not going to lose points because you have acne. It's natural. It's going to happen. Your flaws are what make you beautiful. And if you are empowered and you feel okay and comfortable within yourself, that is all that matters on stage. After sending in your application with your bio and your photos if necessary, if you get in, oh my gosh, you've done it. Well done. If you didn't, that's okay, we'll try again next time. If you feel it's acceptable, maybe reach out to the organizers and ask for feedback. Maybe you did something that they weren't a fan of. This can help you in future applications. And that is all I have to share with you regarding pinup bios and the pinup pageant application process. I really hope these tips help you. If you would like to read any of this information, I have both of my blogs on these topics linked below. There's a little bit more of a description down there and a couple more extra tips, so check that out. Next week, we'll be coming back with a how to plan a pinup routine, so be sure to join us then. If you're not and you would like to be, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, as well as find me on any of my social medias. I would love to have you along for my own little journey of vintage glamour and tomfoolery. There's room for everybody, so come along. I will see you guys all next week, but until then, stay kind, be true, be you, and have a good week. Bye! Pinup bio. A pinup bio, No, we don't want bio. Keep it short and keep it sharp. Did I say sharp or sharp? You don't want people having to grab a microphone. No, you don't want them to grab a microphone, but that's something I need to buy.